Okay, welcome to the phase 2 of the experiment number 4, determination of calorific value of bomb calorimeter of a solid fuel by using bomb calorimeter. So in the phase 1 we have discussed the experimental procedure, the graph we will find at the end of the experiment, the apparatus required, the tools and the steps by steps how to perform the experiment. In stage 2 we will discuss how to measure the weight of the pellet in the digital weight measuring device and how to incorporate the known fuel, the pellets of the benzoic acid inside the bomb. Okay. So, as we have discussed in the phase 1, you can see both the electrodes are joined by using a thread and this is actually a nichrome wire or a very thin nichrome wire or a fuse wire, you can say, because nichrome is widely used in fuse wire, low, very very low melting point, and there are two grooves you can see over there so that it does not tilt, and from the nichrome wire a cotton wire has been placed in the crucible where these three pellets, you can see the three pellets we have prepared in the lab, and these three pellets will be measured in the digital mass measuring device. You can see before we start we need to tear it. The unit is set in gram. Okay. So you can see the gram, the blue, the green color has been switched on here, and this is in other units. So we will place these three and very softly so that it does not break, otherwise the experiment, all the mass will not be calculated. Now you have to make it airtight so that you can make the exact reading. So how much it is?
4.86.
You can see over there 4.860. Okay, so note down 4.860 gram. 4.860 gram. Okay, now close it. Now take it very softly so it does not break, and place it over the crucible in the where the thread is been given. Okay, you can see it. So over the cotton wire it is placed. When the nichrome wire will melt down, so the cotton wire along with the fuel will fall on the crucible. The cotton wire will also burn out. Only the fuel, the known fuel, that with the benzoic acid pellets will burn. So place it gently so that the fuel does not fall outside the crucible. Just place it gently. Now place it, place the cover. Now we will fix it properly and very slowly we will shift this to the oxygen cylinder where a high pressure oxygen will be supplied to the bomb. So this is the oxygen cylinder, you can see. The knob given for oxygen supply has been taken away, and the oxygen and the knob from the oxygen cylinder has been placed over the knob in the bomb. So you have to make sure whether there is enough tight so that there is no lack of you can see we are trying to pull out the you can see oxygen has been raising up. we will make it up to 3 bar. It is now 1.8 bar. By adjusting the knob from the delivery pressure, we will try to make it at 3 bar. So we will adjust it up to 3 bar. Okay. So the you can see over there. So when the 3 bar is reached, that means the inside pressure in the bomb is also 3 bar. So make sure there is no leakage. If there is any leakage, you can use tapping inside the grooves, as well as you can use glycerin or any Vaseline for airtight. Now remove the oxygen supply knob gently so that it does not rupture. Place it away. Place the knob so that no oxygen leaks outside. But remember that the leakage of oxygen is a very important priority. Now first, gently put the bomb in the water container. You can see it is a eccentric for better light. We are shifting it in the light. You can see that the bomb is not at the center due to the adjustment or the space required for the electrical stirrer. The water, you can see, is pouring in such a way so that it does not touch or reach the level of electrode. So beneath the electrode head, you can place the maximum amount of water, and from there, from the measuring flask, you can measure how much water has been taken in the bomb. So there is a, so this is a, so how much amount of water has been taken?
2 liters.
So approximately 2 liters. Okay, 2 liters. Initially 1.5 liter was there, and now we have poured more 500 ml. So 2 liters of water has been taken. Here to put you have to make it in such a way that it does not rotate or falls well, so that it fits well. Yeah. Now place, now you can see this is the stirrer. And you can see this is the thermometer which we have inserted. So this is the thermometer. Place it according to the group given, and before that you just insert the anode and the cathode. See, there is a pin which will be inserted in the pin in the groove, so that it locks. Yeah, it is the digital thermometer. You can see this digital thermometer we need to put on the groove given for the thermometer, and so that the extreme portion of the thermometer is inside the water. Okay, now for now to be ensure whether it is touching the water or not, you need to check by using your finger. Yeah, it is inserted now. These are the two electrodes, one is black, one is so anode and cathode, the two supply from the AC device, so it makes AC to DC. So this is the digital meter box, and we need to insert it on the so the black one, you can see the black one, you need to insert in the black, the red one in the red. So this is your connection, and this is the main supply, you can see. So from there it will come on the AC digital meter box, and you can see the connection. Now you can see the reading of temperature was 19.28. So this will be your T naught. You can see over there 19.28. So if it blinks within 1 minute or 2 minute, we have to wait. So that will be your T naught star. That means from there we will get that the thermometer error, as we have discussed in phase one. You can see 19.26. So in this way, there is a blinking in thermometer due to its technical error or own error. That difference, plus minus error, this is the error inside the thermometer. And you can see this is the main line switch. This is the starter switch. That means the fan is now on and now off. We need to switch it on when the before the experiment is started, so that whatever is the temperature rise in the setup, the it is uniform. And this is the switch for firing, by pressing which will give you a high impulsive current in the circuit. And as we know, Q is equal to I square RT, we know that the fuse wire, the nichrome wire, low melting, it will melt down, and the shorting of anode and cathode will be destroyed. So there will be no connection here, but the initiation of heat is will be from the burning of the fuse wire. The fuse wire will burn, it will start the ignition, so that's why it is given push to fire. That means the firing switch, the firing will be on. And now you can see the voltage is how much, approximately 15 volt here. Okay, the DC supply. Now when the AC supply is approximately 220 volt, but the DC output from the device and input DC supply here in the calorimeter is actually 15 volt, you can see over there. Now when the firing switch is on, when and immediately when the fuse wire will burn and melt down, then there will be no connection. No connection means what? The now we have shown you that anode and cathode is shortened by using the fuse wire. When there will be no fuse wire, so that circuit is broken, and automatically the voltage will drop to zero. So that will indicate that the fuse wire is burnt or not. If it is not coming to zero, that means there is a lack of, or there is a mistake in the setup or in the electrical connection. Okay, so this is whatever. So this is the firing unit of the calorimeter. You can see the firing unit. Okay.
কিছুটা অক্সিজেন আছে করে দাও। কিছুটা অক্সিজেন আছে তো বান্ড হবে এখন। লিক ধীরে ধীরে হচ্ছে তো। দিয়ে দাও ট্রিগার করে দাও।
So first let the firing starter to on. You can see over there. It is rotating. Can you see? So by using this, you can increase the you can increase the speed of the fan by varying the input power of the fan. So let it be optimum. You can see this is still rotating. So if it does not rotate, that means there is a problem in the connection or the friction. So let the firing switch be on. and you can see the difference in the voltage. So ready, 1, 2, 3. You can see the voltage when it is coming to zero, and so the light is been off. That means what? The connection between the anode and cathode is destroyed. When there is no connection, that means the entire the reaction is on. You can see. And now we will note down the rise in temperature. You can see the temperature has started rising. So initially there will be a high increase in temperature in phase 1, in the heating zone. After that there will be a uniformity in temperature, and after that the temperature will drop down, which is the cooling zone. So in the serial number 1, when the time is 0, you can note down the temperature, say 19 point, it was say 29 or 28, whatever. After that, it has become 19.26 or whatever. So from that, but both are before the experiment. So this one is your T naught and this one is your T naught star or whatever. So the difference of these two will give you the thermometer correction, okay. So it will be plus minus 0.02 degree Celsius. So let us take its amount value, so only 0.02, and you can see there is a rise in temperature. So gradually there will be a rise, so it will be say 21, say 24, 27, say it may have to reach up to, say, 43 degree Celsius or whatever. After that, there will be a constant, say 42.9, say 42.8, say again 42.9, 43, like that. So this is the phase 2, that means the equilibrium zone. After that, it will fall down. So after up to this much, if you cover, after that, you need to draw the graph, which will help you to find the cooling correction. The cooling correction formula is that del T del T, in the cooling, C for cooling, into the time for heating. So this is the rate of cooling or rate of temperature fall in cooling, C for cooling. So this T means temperature, small T means time. So rate of temperature fall during cooling into time for heating. So time cancel the temperature difference. This is the, now what is the significance? Now cooling correction is what? When there is a rise in temperature, say 0, say 0 star or whatever, or 0 dashed, 1, 2, 3, 4 in serial number, say it may reach up to say a serial number, say 25. Say 25 to say 29 in serial number, so they are same. And up to 29, up to say 34 or 36, so 37, there is a fall. So what is the significance of this third zone? Whether there is any rise in temperature? No. But what is significance then? The significance is that from this cooling zone, zone 3, we can find the cooling rate. Now this cooling rate, if you multiply with the time for heating, now say 0, say up to 25 minutes there was heating. So I want to know what is the effect of cooling during the 25 minutes. So when the forward reaction was going on, and then also the starter was working, then also there was certain cooling effect in the water because the starter is on, okay. But actually we got heating. So we want to know what is the effect of cooling in water due to the starter and the system during the time of heating. So if it is say 25 minutes and the cooling rate is say 0.03 degree Celsius per minute, so 0.03 into 25, say approximately 0.25 or whatever, this will be the cooling correction. So you can observe that the temperature rise during the experiment with respect to this, the value of cooling correction, the value of thermometer correction is a very low value, which is approximately the sum of these three is approximately equal to the temperature rise in the experiment only. That means these two may be neglected, but in order to get accurate reading, we are doing this. Now, in the calculation portion, the phase one, that means when we are using a known fuel, the known fuel is whatever. So this is a known fuel. The known fuel we have taken as benzoic acid. Why it is known? Because its Cb is known to you. What is Cb? 6,324 calorie per gram. Known to you. So what was the mass of fuel taken in the experiment? 4.86 gram. So 4.86 gram we have taken, we have shown you, into 6324. So calorie per gram into gram will give you calorie. So how much heat is coming out due to the burning of the fuel? So it will be mass 4.86 into 6324, this much of calorie. Now we are assuming that due to, since the nichrome wire, since the nichrome wire will be burnt, it will produce some NO2 inside. Now, if it is mixed with water vapor present in the inside water, it may fall some amount of HNO3, some amount, very little amount. We are assuming the heat which is consumed by the water during the formation of HNO3, the nitric acid, very light, very dilute nitric acid, say approximately, say we are assuming 10 calorie, approximately 10 calorie, we are assuming this. And due to the burning of, say, cotton wire, and due to the ignition of the nichrome wire, some heat is being taken or consumed. This approximately we have taken as 20 calories. So what is the total heat generated? This much, which is approximately, say, whatever, say 5, 6, 30, say approximately, say 28,000 or whatever, plus 10 calorie will come for HNO3, plus 20 calorie will come for the cotton wire burning. So if you add these three, you will get the total heat developed in the calorimeter by burning of the fuel. Now you can say, now we are not taking the direct reading of the combustion chamber. Rather, if this is a bomb, anode and cathode, here the crucible, the fuse wires are already melt down, so there is no connection now. The fuse wire is burnt and the fuels are burnt. There are three pillars wire there, both, all the pillars need to be burned in order to ensure the correctness or and the completeness of the experiment. So here we are having water, so around the bomb, very less here, but maximum here. So the thermometer is connected here, digital thermometer in Celsius reading. Now this thermometer is actually counting the temperature of water, not of inside the bomb. And as we are stirring by using a paddle wheel, this is rotating, so there is a uniform rise in temperature in the water. So we can say the total heat from the setup. So which one? Say 28,000, say 30 or whatever. I'm not going into the calculation. That entire heat is actually heating the water. So I can write M into S into delta T, rise in water. Now tell me, this M into S, this is what? This is the actually water equivalent of the device. But now we are not considering this one, because in the total experiment, what is the total mass? The mass of dry device, that means the calorimeter device, plus the mass of water. Now we need to find the water equivalence of the calorimeter. So we need to subtract the amount of mass of water taken. Now this one is the total mass. This S is the specific heat of the total calorimeter device. So from that we can write, this M is the M total. Now what is delta T in the rise, which is this one. Okay, that means the delta T experiment plus thermometer correction plus cooling correction. So I can write this entire heat, whatever, is actually M total into S total into delta T water rise, delta T rise in water, which is actually the sum of these three, delta T in experiment plus delta plus TC plus TT, all the correction factor plus this one. So this is already known to you. How to find the experimental rise in temperature of in water? You can see the minimum temperature after the experiment is started is not T naught. Because T naught is initial. T naught star is also initial. When the experiment is on, we actually got T1. So start from T1. And say the experiment will, the maximum temperature is say T5. So it is T max. So T1 is here actually T mean, and T say 25 say is actually say T max. It may be T30 also, depending on your the mass of the fuel and the water taken and other parameters. So what will be delta T maximum? Maximum temperature rise in water. T max minus T mean. So T max minus of T min. So this is the maximum temperature rise. That means the 25th reading of water temperature and the first reading T1, not T naught. T naught is initial before the experiment. So take it very much important. So we got this one. So this is equal to say T max minus T min. That means from the graph we can easily say. Okay, here is the temperature versus time. Now, this M into this one. Now, we are trying to convert. Now, there are two ways. In the first technique, we can write from this one, if this is the water equivalence of the device into delta T total rise in water, that means the sum of these three temperature with the correction factor, total rise in temperature of water in water side. It is also known. So this is also known. So what we can find out? The water equivalence of the device. What is the unit? K. ক্যালোরি অর ইউনিট অফ দিস ওয়ান ডিগ্রি সেলসিয়াস, সো ইন ক্যালোরি পার ডিগ্রি সেলসিয়াস, দিস ইজ দ্য ফার্স্ট স্টেপ। নাও দ্য হোয়াট দ্য সিগনিফিকেন্স, দিস ইজ দ্য ওয়াটার ইকুইভ্যালেন্স অর ইকুইভ্যালেন্ট অফ দ্য এন্টায়ার ডিভাইস, অল দ্য অ্যাপারেটাস, অল ওয়াটার হোয়াট এভার ইজ দেয়ার, বম, ইলেকট্রোড, দ্য এন্টায়ার ইউনিট ইজ বিং কনসিডার্ড। বাট ইফ ইউ ওয়ান্ট টু নো ইন টার্ম, সে ইন ক্লাস 9-10 অর 11-12 ইউ স্টাডিড দ্য ইউনিট অফ ওয়াটার ইকুইভ্যালেন্স ইজ সাম অ্যামাউন্ট অফ মাস অফ ওয়াটার। হোয়াট ইজ দ্য ওয়াটার ইকুইভ্যালেন্স অফ দিস চক, ইফ এনিবডি আস্ক ইউ হোয়াট ইজ দ্য অ্যান্সার, দ্য অ্যান্সার ইজ ইফ দিস চক ইজ বার্নড ইন প্রেজেন্স অফ অক্সিজেন, আফটার কমপ্লিট বার্নিং ইট উইল গিভ ইউ সাম অ্যামাউন্ট অফ হিট, হোয়াট এভার এক্স ওয়াই জেড, বাই ইউজিং দ্যাট হিট ইফ দ্য টেম্পারেচার রাইজ অফ সাম অ্যামাউন্ট অফ ওয়াটার ইজ 1 ডিগ্রি সেলসিয়াস, দ্যাট মাস অফ ওয়াটার ইজ কল্ড দ্য ওয়াটার ইকুইভ্যালেন্স অফ দিস চক। সো অ্যাকচুয়ালি ওয়াটার ইকুইভ্যালেন্স সিগনিফাইজ সাম অ্যামাউন্ট অফ মাস অফ ওয়াটার, সো ইট শুড বি এক্সপ্রেসড ইকুইভ্যালেন্টলি ইন টু সাম গ্রাম অফ ওয়াটার। সো হোয়াট গ্রাম অফ ওয়াটার অর সে হোয়াট কেজি অফ ওয়াটার, ক্লিয়ার? সে ইউ গট এ অ্যান্সার, সে 4000, সে 300, হোয়াট এভার, সে 65 অর হোয়াট এভার, সে রাফ ভ্যালু আই এম টেকিং। হাউ টু কনভার্ট ইন টু ইকুইভ্যালেন্টলি ইন দ্য ইউনিট অফ মাস অফ ওয়াটার? নাও হোয়াট ইজ দ্য টোটাল মাস অফ দ্য এন্টায়ার, বিকজ ইজ দ্য ডিভাইস, অ্যান্ড ডিভাইস মিন্স আই টোল্ড ইউ দ্য ড্রাই ক্যালোরিমিটার প্লাস দ্য ওয়াটার ইউজড, অ্যান্ড উই হ্যাভ টেকেন ওয়াটার অফ 2 লিটার। Now, you can see 1 liter water means approximately 1000 ml volume. So, volume to volume. 1 ml means 1 cc, cubic centimeter, equivalent to 1000 gram of water. Because in CGS unit, the specific heat of water, the density of water, if you take pure water, is approximately 1 gram per cc. Or it may be in SI, 10 cube kg per meter cube. So, 1 liter water means 1000 gram of water. That means 1 kg of water. So, 1 liter water will give you the mass of 1 kg. If the water considered is a pure water. If pure, we are considering no darkness. Ideal case. So, 2 liter water we have taken, that means approximately weight is, mass is 2 kg. So, 2 liter of water is approximately 2 kg of water. Volume to mass. So from this line we can write the mass of water plus the mass of device, that means the calorimeter, device means total, the dry device, dry device means the calorimeter, plus dry plus weight is the total weight, total mass, into Cp of water into the delta T total rise in water is again 28,000, this much, or if you can subtract, so this is the water equivalence of the device which we have already discussed, same thing, 4365 calorie per gram. Why calorie per gram? With the unit of Cp is calorie per gram per degree Celsius, 2 celsius or in SI I can convert it into what, joule per kg kelvin or this is whatever, same thing. So what is the mass of the water taken? 2 liter water volume, so 2 kg means how much gram? 2000 gram. So 2000 gram plus this unknown, the dry device is actually into what is CP of water, approximately 4.18 or 4187. It is in joule per kg degree Celsius. So we have to convert this into CGS unit. It is equal to 4365 calorie per degree Celsius. So units are not matched. This is in gram, this is in joule per kg Kelvin, this is in calorie per degree Celsius. So better convert it into gram, calorie per gram degree Celsius. How? 4.1487. 1 joule is equal to 1 by 4.187. Or you could say approximately 4.2 RK. Approximately. This much of calorie. How much? 1 kg? 1000 gram? And degree Celsius is there. So this is 1. So 10 to the power minus 3. So 10 to the power minus 3 approximately calorie per gram degree Celsius. So put it here in CGS unit, 10 to the power minus 3 calorie per gram. So you can see gram is cancelled. What is the unit? Calorie per degree Celsius. So unit are matched. Okay, so in this way you can find this one, the mass of the calorimeter. So you can either express the water equivalence in terms of calorie per degree Celsius, but this is not the significance wise, this is not the exact unit. So you can convert into equivalence mass of the dry device we are having. In terms of what? Kg of water. Say after doing that, you say you have got say 7300, say 15 or whatever gram of water. So that is, that means the equivalence weight is 7.315 kg. That means the dry device is equivalently having this amount of mass of water in terms of the calorific value. So this reading, whatever we will get today, that you need to incorporate in the phase 2. And remember, the phase 2, the same amount of mass of water, that means 2000 gram, that is 2 liter of water has to be taken. Otherwise, we cannot match it. Okay? So thank you.